Module-based planning provides complete planning and budgeting solutions for financials, workforce, capital, projects, and strategic modeling with built-in best practice predefined content, including forms, calculations, dashboards, drivers, and key performance indicators. Workforce provides integrated drivers that help you link financial plans with workforce plans that include headcount and compensation planning. In planning, navigate to the Configure page. On the Configure page, you can enable strategic modeling, financials, workforce, capital, and projects. I'll configure workforce. In Enable Features, select predefined drivers, categories, and options. While you can enable more features later, Oracle recommends that you enable only the features that planners currently require. You can't disable features later. You can select which level of detail to manage workforce expenses. I'll select employee and job. I'll be planning for compensation and non-compensation expenses, as well as headcount, which will include employee demographic details. I'll also plan expenses based on employee or job hiring, terminating, and transferring to another department. You can map dimensions to establish a relationship between multiple modules. I'll associate a custom dimension with a dimension in projects. By linking these dimensions, I won't have to rebuild a common dimension when I enable a new module. You cannot change dimensions or dimension names after enabling features. Always review your selections before proceeding. Enabling features takes a moment to complete. When a message box displays that workforce was enabled successfully, log off and log back on to see your changes. Notice the workforce cluster on the home page. Let's return to the configure page. Here are the features I enabled. If you need to enable additional predefined features, go to Enable Features. You can import members for workforce components such as grades, taxes, benefits, and additional earnings. I'll verify the import process completed successfully in Jobs. If you have all your metadata files ready, you can import them all at once using the Batch Import option. After importing workforce components, you can configure salary grades. You can set benefits, earnings, and tiers in Options and Tiers. I'll add a few options. Now, I'll configure the details in Benefits and Taxes. Our organization uses a rate table and maps fringe rate benefits to the other benefits financial account. There are several choices for payment terms. For the monthly, quarterly, and annual options, you can calculate expenses for either the fiscal or calendar year. This benefit will be calculated based on a percentage of the employee's salary and is not a taxable component. Next, I'll enter fringe rates. Workforce assumptions are used to calculate salary from salary grade rates. Assumptions drive the calculations for salary expenses. From the Configure page, you can load information for non-compensation expenses, employee, job, skill set, and others the same way you loaded components. In compensation planning, let's set default assumptions for salary. Salary, additional earnings, benefits, and taxes are calculated based on the assumptions that you define. Next, let's add defaults for benefits. I'll assign medical and fringe benefits to all jobs. And I'll include car allowances for the sales director and sales VP. After adding defaults, you can edit them in the form. After you complete the configuration of your workforce components, you can import data for existing employees. For more information, view the Loading Data in Planning tutorial and video on docs.oracle.com. After you load your employee data, run the rule to synchronize defaults. For information on updating multiple employee and job data and synchronizing defaults, View the Performing Employee and Job Mass Updates tutorial. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.